Hello friends, this video is about conservative force. We see a lot of forces around us and we have studied that some of the forces are contact forces and some are non-contact forces. Okay, here we will be dividing the force into two categories. Number one is a conservative force and number two is a non-conservative force. What exactly is the meaning of a conservative force? Let us check that. See, if force is conservative, if the work done by that force is path independent, that means if a particular force is moving a body through one path and if it is moving the same body through a different path and if the work done by both the paths is equal, then we say that the force is conservative. I have seen many students, even after passing class 12th, they give a wrong definition of conservative force. Hope you will not do that. When I ask what is a conservative force, they say, if the force does not depend upon distance, it depends only on displacement, that is a conservative force. Wrong. It is actually the work done by that force that should be path independent. Yani ke agar koi force work kar raha hai, तो वो रास्ते पे डिपेंड ना करे, सिर्फ इनिशियल और फाइनल पोजीशंस पर ही डिपेंड करे. क्या फोर्स? नहीं, द वर्क डन बाय दैट फोर्स. सो इफ द वर्क डन बाय दैट फोर्स इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ द पाथ, देन इट इज सेड टू बी ए कंजर्वेटिव फोर्स. एंड इफ इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द पाथ, इट विल बी नॉन कंजर्वेटिव फोर्स. वी विल बी लुकिंग एट द एग्जांपल्स ऑफ वन कंजर्वेटिव फोर्स एंड वन नॉन कंजर्वेटिव फोर्स. हियर, how to check whether a force is conservative or non-conservative? Very simple technique. See, this is point A and this is the final point Z. I will bring a body from A to Z through direct path and then I will move the same body through an indirect path, that is from A to B, then to C and then to Z. If the work done from this straight path A to Z is equal to the work done through this path, ठीक है, क्या करना है? Check the work done by this path and by this path. तीनों का work done लो, उसे add करो. If that work done is equal to work done on this path, then your force will be conservative force. Clear? Using the same technique, we will check whether gravitational force is conservative or non-conservative. So I have a body of mass m which is moved up to a distance h by a straight path. You know what is the work done? Force into displacement, displacement angle between them is 180. So this gives mgh into minus 1 and work done in this path is equals to minus mgh. Now calculating the work done through a different path. Okay, this path is divided into four different parts, A, then B, then C, and then D. Let us find the work done through all these paths, 1, 2, 3, and 4. W1 is the work done from here to here. So what is the work done? Force into displacement, cos 180. Displacement is upwards, force is downwards. The angle between them will be 180. So this is minus 1, and so the work done is minus MGA. Work done in the second path, that is from here to here, covering a distance B. Force, gravitational force is mg, displacement is equals to B, but here the angle between force and displacement is 90 degrees. Where is the direction of gravitational force? It is downwards. Where is direction of displacement? It's towards your right side. So what's the angle between force and displacement? It is 90. Cos 90 stands to be 0. So work done in the second path is equal to 0. You can check by yourself work done by from this point to this point, that is W3. How much it is? It is minus MGC, just like jaise W1 calculate kiya tha, waise W3. Okay, W4, work done from this point to this point. Again, what is the angle between them? Force and displacement ke beech ka angle kitna hoga? 0. So work done from here to here again becomes equals to 0. And now when I add W1, W2, W3 and W4, the total work done I am finding for this path, that will be what? Minus MGA minus MGC, and when you add them you will get this A plus C. What is A plus C? A plus C is equals to H. So what is the total work done? The total work done is equals to minus MGH. So, the work done through this path or through this path, are they equal? Yes, they are equal. So, from this, can I say the gravitational force is conservative force? Definitely.